Is there anyone in your village that you would date?
Nah.
I went there, and 21 days later we were married.
พ่อแม่ไม่อยากให้แต่งงานกับคนต่างชาติ
Did I choose the wrong husband?
Ganun ka ano kung anong naiisip ko, akala ko yung katulad sa New York.
It must be harder to meet someone when you live on the Faroe Islands in a small village.
Yeah, and for a picky guy like me, it's impossible.
Do you want to get married?
Yes, I do. But that's a big step. Yeah, but I'm pretty sure if I find a wife, it will be somewhere else.
What are you doing to find your foreign woman?
Just waiting and keeping my ears and eyes open.
Bjørt has an air of something old world about him. He's polite, but doesn't always look you in the eye, which he describes as a typical Faroese trait. Somehow he knows his future partner is not here in the Faroes. So what is this?
This is supposed to be a rhubarb garden. Now everybody got their hobbies. This is all one of mine.
How long have you been working on this?
3 years. 3 years. I will be finishing this year. This is actually the finishing touch.
Single men in the Faroes face a challenge, a shortage of women. And for centuries, many like Bjørt have worked out at sea, making the search for love even more difficult.
I'm a fisherman, and it's like half of the year I'm gone. So it's never easy being a fisherman's wife. And usually when you're home, there's a lot to do. Things get broken while you're gone, you have to fix. And now it's summer and there's a lot of do. We are like painting in a house or renovating and building my wall. We have a saying in Faroe Islands, a crow doesn't shit in its own nest. So it just means you go dating outside your area. Stay away from your village.
The Faroes are made up of 18 islands, an old Viking settlement now part of Denmark. The landscape is both breathtaking and brutal. Nothing grows here, not even trees. Men were traditionally fishermen and women homemakers. But women started leaving the island in search of a better life.
Jeg skulle have en uddannelse. Der er andre jobs i storbyen. Altså, der er større organisationer, og man bliver en spiller på i et større felt.
Men det er altså, et underskud af kvinder. Omkring 2.000 flere mænd eller sådan en gang. Jeg tror, at det tal er blevet lidt mindre nu, men man snakker om, at der er flere udlandske kvinder her. Fordi at der er simpelthen, vi mangler kvinder.
Is there anyone in your village that you would date? Are you open to meeting someone on the internet?
Yeah, I think so. Maybe you meet an interesting person on Facebook. That would be actually a possibility. You have a lot in common, and maybe you want to meet sometimes just over like if she lives in another country, just meet or just say hi. You go traveling in her country and you just find like sparks flying. That actually could work.
And it is working, bringing cultural diversity along with it for the first time. In Australia, multiculturalism arrived after war. In the Faroes, it's here because of internet dating. Pat and her husband met online, but she lied to her parents about their first meeting. She told them she was going to Australia with a girlfriend, but secretly flew to the Faroes.
I hear the Faroese women are very good looking after babies and changing nappies.
Yeah.
Would you say that's true?
Yeah, definitely. We try to follow everything. And the equal right and so on, so yeah, of course.
What Faroese things from your culture will you make sure that he has?
That he will go on with Faroese tradition about food. So some dry lamb and whale meat and yeah, everything that is with the Faroese culture with food. That's very important. What are you cooking today?
It's a pork soup.
Okay.
You want to try?
Definitely
yeah,
not.
Yeah, please try. It's not so spicy.
No, definitely not.
You
definitely
never tried the Thai food.
Of course not. Not good.
After 2 years of getting to know each other online and a secret one-week visit, they decided to marry, which upset her parents.
Eric will not eat well.
Yes, he will.
Nice.
Pat left a job in Bangkok as an assistant manager and now works as a supermarket cleaner. She's his second wife, and Eric, their baby, his second son. Bjergi was married before to an Indonesian woman.
So this is my family, my older son, Karen, and Eric, and my missus.
ด้วยวัฒนธรรมที่ต่างกันที่บ้านเป็นคนที่เคร่งในระเบียบมากๆเลยแล้วก็ต้องเคารพผู้ใหญ่มากๆแต่คนฝรั่งตรงนี้ไม่มีเขาก็เลยกลัวว่าเราจะลืมตรงนั้นไปและอีกอย่างอยู่ไกลด้วยเขาก็เลยไม่อยากให้มาอยู่ทุกวันนี้เขาก็ยังยอมรับไม่ได้แต่เขาก็ไม่รู้จะทำยังไง
For me, I have problem about my look. I'm not the nice people or beautiful woman, but he said you are beautiful inside. Yeah. Actually, you are beautiful. Yeah, so I said, oh, maybe this man is good for me at the beginning.
What was the hardest thing to get used to?
ภาษานี่ยากมากๆเลยพยายามเรียน2รอบแล้วเข้าใจบ้าง 70% แต่ว่าถ้าจะพูดเนี่ยคงลำบากคือสิ่งที่ยากที่สุดตอนที่เขาไปรวมกับครอบครัวสามีเนี่ยเขาพูดภาษาแล้วเราไม่เข้าใจมันก็ทำให้หน้าเบื่ออยู่ในกลุ่มนั้นบางครั้งก็ไม่อยากไปอยากจะอยู่แต่ในบ้าน
Why didn't you date a Faroese woman? What is it about the Asian woman that you prefer?
Actually, it's nothing about Asian or whatever. I was just actually on the internet about talking about sport, football and so on, and meet her. And yeah, it's just meet like that. Well, it's not about, about Asian or whatever. It's just that we fit together by talking, so that's why.
คือก่อนหน้านี้เคยได้ยินมาว่าคนฝรั่งไม่เจ้าชู้แต่คนไทยเนี่ยเจ้าชู้อีกอย่างหนึ่งลูกออกมาลูกครึ่งคงจะน่ารักน่าดู
This is pilot whale blubber. This is actually the outside skin of the pilot whale.
She has no regrets and bought their house using her cleaner salary.But she knows not everyone who comes to the Faroes is here for love.
ก็มีนะคนที่แต่งงานเพื่อผลประโยชน์ของตัวเองเพื่อให้จะได้อยู่ที่นี่มีงานทำรู้สึกแย่เหมือนกันเพราะต่างจากของเราก็เชื่อว่าคงมีอีกหลายคนที่คิดเช่นนั้น
If she tries one whale blubber, will you try one spring roll?
Yeah.
Oi!There's more one.
No. If I have to eat a whole one there, then you have to eat a whole one here.
No, this one.
Okay. Eat it.
How was it?
I don't know. I just walked.
No, this is not me.
Did I shoot the wrong husband?
In the year 2000, there were only 30 Southeast Asian women living in the Faroes. Now the number is estimated to be 300. But mixing cultures isn't always easy.
At school, I was the only Chinese girl in my class.Actually, I was the only Chinese kid in school. And one of the things I fought a lot with my parents about was how to integrate into the community. You want to do it in a way that's respectful to the culture that you're from, but also you kind of want to fit and blend into the community that you live in. And it's difficult, you know, there's no easy solutions.
Why is everyone here?
Because we married a Faroese man here, that's why. Yeah, we found our love of our life.
And how long have you been here?
I've been here for 10 years now. Some people are nice and some people are rude, some people are racist. So, different people, different cultures.
Though no one says it out loud, I hear a small handful of localsuse cruel labels such as eBay wives.
Babe, I wanna live forever.
The women working at the salmon factory say they learn Faroese and knitting to help fit in.
Baby, remember my name, remember.
But on the weekends, you'll find them together with their husbands, enjoying that favorite Filipino pastime.
I'm Pam Marianne.Just like I like everything, but she's very good to cook.
It's very cute.
I went there, and 21 days later we were married. And if you believe there would be no problems, if you do that, you're of course wrong, and I knew that, but you can take the problems as they come. I like Asian women, yeah, of course, yeah. They're pretty, they're beautiful, they're sweet.
The Faroese women are not pretty and beautiful and sweet.
Some are, of course, but there is much more to choose between there and Asia.
When I came here,We were only about 50 Filipino women. And then now I think we are already 150 or more.
I learned some women are living in villages with less than 20 residents. Beert's village has 700 people, with five Asian women calling it home.
It's like 150 years old, this house. It's kind of old way people used to live.
In this house, in the old days, there was serious many children usually. It's like I have like two grandfathers. One of them was like 18 children. The other one was 14. Poor woman, poor women.
Do you ever think about the foreign women that have come to your village and who have married Faroese men? Mm. Do you ever think about how difficult it is for them to adjust to this hard life on this isolated island?
Yeah, I do actually. Coming from a country where there live like several millions, hundreds of millions, into a country where there live 50,000, and completely strange, different climate, minus 10 degrees in winter, never warmer than 18, 20 degrees in summer. I think a lot of them must have thought about turning back to Asia.
Lena's mum came here from Thailand 25 years ago and never looked back, making Lena one of the first mixed-race children born on the island. She's incredibly proud of her hand-knitted national Faroese costume that she wears together with a special Thai scarf. I have a lot in common with Lena. We were both the only children in our schools with Asian heritage. Lena says she's never had the chance to share similar experiences, and I'm keen to hear what it was like for her.
Where are you taking us?
We're going to Strandur, which is my hometown, to visit my aunt's restaurant. We're gonna have a family dinner later tonight.
Are there any other restaurants in Strandur?
No. This one, which is my aunt's, which is Thai food.
Are you looking for a Faroese man or a Thai man?
Well, that's hard to say, but no, I would like to have a Faroese man, I think.
What was it like for you growing up?
You think you're like just like the other children, and then someone comes to you and says, no, you're different and your mother's not from here. And then you just wake up and see that you're not like the other kids, then who are you?
Vi har förska mentan syr hetta och thainska mentan och är som uppväxt runt från mamma och syr hetta. Och så ständ man mitt och man vill inte skuffa näkran eller så det är onkel du är sin förvirrande.
Lena's parents married in the early 90s, introduced together by Lena's aunt, who also married a Faroese man. There were never any other nationalities in Lena's life, not even at university. For me at that age, I moved to a big city and got a chance to meet people from around the world. For Lena, the only people like her were her family.
This is my father, my little sister, my little brother, and my mom.
การสอนลูกคือมีสองวัฒนธรรมคือวัฒนธรรมไทยแล้วก็วัฒนธรรมนี่คืออันสิ่งไหนดีแล้วก็อยู่นี่สิ่งไหนดีแล้วก็สอนลูกแล้วก็เอาวัฒนธรรมไทยมาดูกัน
This is my aunt. She just served in festivals, like in her carriage, like a booth. And that's how it started, and now she's here in her own restaurant, which is amazing.
Lena?
Yes,
yeah.
Okay.
It's not easy to keep up with the Jakobsen family dinner conversation. Occasionally, they use Google to translate words with each other.
What language do you speak when you're all together?
Faroese, first.
Sometimes Thai.
English.
We have been mixing it since I met her.
So it was English and a little bit of Thai mixed together, and then she learned Faroese.
Were you worried growing up for your children about how well they would be accepted?
No, not when they were small. I never thought about that, but sometimes they grew up, because then they were so few at the moment when they were growing up. There was not so many, but they are getting more and more. It's more easy to notice them. And some people always will call other people names.
Mm. And as a father, how does that make you feel?
It makes me sorry, because they are my kids, so if somebody hurts them, I get hurt as well. So.
Det var väldigt gott att höra pappa ta sånt där faktiskt. Du vet jag släcker snack om det. När jag säger du familjen, du och din familj, vi är ju bara, alltså vi tar inte följt och kun övervisa eller så. Övervisa eller inte en lojka eller så, så vi tar bara go to you av it då på händer mattan och så vill när jag berätta annor go till och kom för det.
Lena tells me I can't leave the Faroes without visiting Saksun Beach. She arranges for a barbecue with friends. And despite feeling isolated as a child, it strikes me how comfortable she is now in Faroese culture. During summer, it's light here nearly 24 hours. And as we walk from the car park, it looks like mid-afternoon, but right now it's already 9 o'clock at night.
Hey, du tänker jag?
Ich wohne grill.
She ever talked about it with you guys about what it's like to be part Thai and part Faroese? What did she say?
Yeah.
What did she say?
Att det var sånt där harst för att jag skulle ha dem.
Så att jag vet att föreningar är ju vänner vi utlänningar för jung. Och folk, ja, jag vet inte, alltså det hittar och det känns som man är akkurat Anna än en föreningar.
But you said that you felt that people didn't see you as a Faroese people when you walked out in the city.
But I've never thought about it like that.
Lena and her friends will only see more diversity in the Faroes as they get older. There are now 117 nationalities here. A new generation of Faroese in this old world place.
Jag var ju där för att tåsa här i Faroe. Och det här gör att det är inte Köpenhamn eller London. Eller så. Det här är där man är multikulturellt. Och kanske är det upplagt för mig att och för det här. Visst det var det här. Faroe är det mot hörn. Och med de bästa vi är här. Så jag ska långa med. Jag ska bara vara här. Jesus, Jesus.